Auntie Chantel. Good afternoon.
And what are you doing in my sitting room wearing your school uniform?
I'm waiting for my mom and Uncle Mark.
Your mother and my fiance?
Yes, my uncle drove her out. Is there any problem?
My fiance drove your mother? Why?
Well, she fainted and he had to drive her to the hospital.
Oh, and why did she get a cab?
Because unconscious people don't order rides.
Jesus Christ!
Baby!
Oh, it's finished! Baby! Sam, help! Help!
Sam, please help me. My daughter is dying, please. My daughter is dying, sir. Help me.
What is it? Annabelle! So it's finished!
I told you that come to me whenever you need anything. I've told you repeatedly. I keep repeating myself. Huh?
Sir, honestly speaking, I didn't want to bother you. I mean, I'm tired of coming to you every now and then to ask for assistance. I'm your staff, not your wife nor your sister.
You don't want to bother me. You don't want to bother me. Now see where this, I don't want to bother you, sir. See where this got in us to. Just look at it. Fine, yeah. You're my staff. But before being my staff, you are human. And it's just normal. It is normal for me to help whatever way I can to help a human being. Okay? So if you need anything, whatever you need, do not hesitate. Come to me. Is that clear?
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir. God bless you. Thank you.
It's okay.
I'm so sorry to have bothered you.
No problem.
Okay. Yeah. I'll just be in the room.
Okay, how is she?
She's better.
All right.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. How are you, Emily?
And how was it?
Okay. Now, do not scare me again like you did last night. Is that clear? Promise?
Yes, I do.
Promise?
Promise.
Yeah. Awesome. Okay. Goodbye.
No, sir. I want to take her to school.
The bag.
Sir, our school is not very far from here, and then I don't want to stress you anymore.
Anna, have you forgotten what we discussed just last night?
Sorry, sir. Sir, good. Are you sure?
I'm sure. So, I'll take her to school today, and I'll bring her back from school today.
Okay, sir.
All right, so let's go.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Good.
My woman is coming today, okay? And I want you to prepare something very nice for her.
Sure, sir.
Your skills.
Okay. Bye. Good afternoon, Ma.
Afternoon. Anna, right?
Yes, Ma. You're welcome, Ma.
And why were you spreading out on my couch like you bought them?
I'm sorry, Ma.
Mark didn't tell me you were deaf. I repeat, why were you spreading out on my couch like you can afford them? Huh?
It won't happen again, Ma.
Oh, there she goes again. I didn't ask for an apology. I asked a question.
Ma.
No? Here, take this to my room. Be fussed about it. Move it! Lazy asshole. Just give me a glass of water in the way. In less than 2 hours since I got back, you've said sorry twice. What the hell is wrong with you? Wait, don't tell me this is how you barge into my fiance's room.
No, Ma. I only came to dress the bed because Oga wouldn't be happy with me if he comes back. Touching your bag was a mistake. I'm sorry.
Now you listen. This should never repeat itself. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Else you will find yourself in the dustbin where you belong. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Better. Now, what do you want?
Ma, it's time for me to go pick my daughter from school. So I wanted to know if you need me to do anything for you before leaving.
And of what business of that is mine? You want to go and pick your daughter up from school. How is it my business?
Sorry, Ma.
And did I ask you for help? Did I?
No, Ma.
Okay. Is the table set?
Yes, Ma.
Good. Now get out.
Okay, Ma.
Out.
Why do you ask?
Because you've been unusually quiet. What is it?
Nothing. I'm just tired.
So we're on a nothing basis now, right? Look, I know you too well. And I don't need a seer to know that something is wrong. Mom, tell me, what is it?
Do you know me too well?
Of course I do. I've spent at least 12 hours every day of my entire life with you. So tell me, what is it?
His fiance.
Who's fiance?
Oga Mark, of course.
Oh, she's here. That's so nice. I can't wait to meet her though. Let's go.
If I were you, I wouldn't be so eager.
I don't understand. You just said that Uncle Mark's fiance is here, which means the woman he wants to marry is here.
She is, but she's not Uncle Mark. Well, I just need you to be careful around her and then try not to upset her. Do you hear me?
Okay.
Good. Come. Let's go inside.
Hello.
afternoon, Auntie. My name is Amanda and I'm Uncle Mark's friend.
You are what?
Uncle Mark's friend.
No, my darling, you are not.
You are the child of Uncle Mark's help. That is what you are.
Yes, Auntie.
Good. And you? Why did you add so much pepper to the food?
Mr. Mark likes pepper, so...
How dare you? You dare call my fiance by his first name?
Sorry, ma.
Oh, God. What the hell is wrong with you and sorries? I asked a simple question that demands a simple answer and you jump to apologies. I ask you again. Why is there so much pepper in my food?
Oga Mark likes pepper a lot, so I figured you'd like it too.
And do I look like Oga Mark?
No, ma.
First time she answers my question without an apology. That's a good one. Now you listen. I am not my fiance. Henceforth, you have to start making our food separately. Understood?
Okay, ma.
Good. Now get out. Out. Scallywat.
Mr. Mark has been like a brother, a father, and an amazing boss. But it seems his fiance Chantel doesn't like my daughter and I. God, please. Don't let him chase us out because of her. Dear Lord, please grant me this wish of Amanda staying close to his heart as always. Please.
Hi, baby.
Oh, my God.
I missed you so much.
I missed you too. And how was your flight?
It was safe.
Safe.
How was what?
Oh, same as yesterday, day before. Same, no change. But our guest today is going to be better because my woman is around.
Of course, 100%.
Right?
Baby,
yeah.
We're going to choose our wedding dates tonight, right?
I'm with you on this.
Okay.
Trust me, I love you so much.
I love you more.
And I miss her. So, where's Anna?
She's in the kitchen.
Anna! Anna!
Sir. Uncle Mark!
Come here. Oh. Lay down.
Let's go, sir.
Oh. Yeah, how are you? Yeah, and how was school today?
It was very fun. Guess what?
What?
I scored 10 over 10 in that assignment you assisted me with.
Wow! I wasn't expecting anything else, okay? I know how brilliant you are.
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
welcome, sir.
I got this for you.
Oh. Sir, I put one yesterday.
It is better too much than not enough. Okay? I don't want what happened the last time to repeat itself again.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you,
you're
sir.
Welcome.
May God bless you.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Calm down. Oh, baby.
Yeah, darling.
Why don't we go upstairs so you freshen up? No. And Anna?
Yes, ma.
How long before the food is set?
15 minutes, ma.
Good.
Good.
Let's go, baby.
Okay. Right. Oh, Chantel. No more.
Thank you.
we have to eat in the room today because Uncle Mark needs some privacy with Madame.
But let her eat. Okay? Mm-hmm.
Baby, but she's right. They can eat in the room.
No. Nobody eats in the room in my house. Everybody eats on the dining table. Right?
So we can eat.
Where's your food?
Kitchen.
Go get it.
Okay, sir.
Amanda, go ahead. Sweetheart, come on. Get your food. Nice. 6. So you got this 12 plus 2, huh?
Oh, yeah. Then you see that you times it by 2.
So you times it by 2.
Baby, yeah. It's bedtime already.
Okay, just go out, join me soon, okay? Let me just help us solve this homework.
Yes.
Alright?
Baby, she should be able to do it herself. I mean, you're not going to keep helping her forever.
She's my friend forever. Forever, right?
Sure.
Forever. So, let's go.
Okay.
I thought you had slept. You're still awake.
Why did you have to embarrass me in front of them?
Embarrass you in front of them? I don't understand. When? How? In front of who?
In the living room.
I truly don't know what you're talking about.
Putting anyone or anything ahead of my need is the height of disrespect.
You're really confusing me here. I don't understand. I'm confused.
Okay. Let me break it down.
Break it.
Choosing to assist Amanda do her homework instead of coming with me to the room is enough disrespect, Mark.
No, I don't get it. All I asked was for you to give me some time. Just some time for me to, you know, get through with the assignment with the little girl before coming to the room. You refused. Okay, fine. Now look at it. I am here. Am I not here with you?
Oh, God. Okay, baby, fine. Listen. I really think there are certain things we need to readdress in this house. I am your fiance, right?
Yes.
And soon to be your wife. Mm-hmm. Hence, I should have equal say, or if not majority, in how the affairs of this house should be conducted.
Of course you are.
Am I?
100%. You are 100% in control. Babe, so let me tell you. I mean, everything. I mean, the house, the entire house is in your control. My responsibility is to provide for you. That's it.
Okay.
Good. So are you good now?
Mm-hmm.
So can you go to bed now?
Okay.
So, can we sleep now? Come on. So, just shower and join you. Okay?
Upstairs, I want to do the laundry.
Are they my fiancés?
Oh no. They're my daughter's clothes.
Oh. Really?
Yes. Wait. You mean you use my washing machine to do your daughter's laundry?
It was Mark that asked me to.
Don't you ever refer to my fiance by his first name. Have I made myself clear?
Okay, ma.
Good. I don't care whatever he told you. I don't give a damn about whatever agreement you guys had in the past. But I am here now. I take charge over everything. Henceforth, the only clothes that I want interacting with my washing machine are that of mine and my fiance's. Understood?
Okay, ma.
Good. You are nothing but a house help. Your duty is to clean and cook in this house. So don't incur unnecessary expenses for us.
Sorry about that, ma.
It's all right. You can run along now. Get out of my sight. Get out! Foolish girl.
Where's your mom?
I didn't see her. I don't know where she is.
She's not in the kitchen.
No, she's not.
She's not in the room.
No.
Or maybe she went out with Auntie Chantal.
I doubt that. My mother will not go out with that auntie.
Why?
Nothing. Let me look for her outside. Maybe she's outside.
And what are you doing in my sitting room wearing your school uniform?
I'm waiting for my mom and Uncle Mark.
Your mother and my fiance?
Yes, my uncle drove her out. Is there any problem?
My fiance drove your mother? Why?
Well, she fainted and he had to drive her to the hospital.
Oh, and why did she get a cab?
Because unconscious people don't order rides.
Joshua got me pregnant and promised he was going to come with his people to see my people. A week passed by. Joshua didn't show up and tried reaching me. I decided to go to his place myself. But he denied me before his people. his mother came to our house and insulted my parents, asking them to warn their daughter to stay off their son. My father, who was an elder in the church, could not stand the pain and the shame. So he disowned me. Yes. I went to stay with my school mother, who insisted she could not continue feeding me unless I joined her line of business. A few weeks after giving birth to Amanda, she was so small because of malnutrition. I became so scared that she was going to die. So, I did it.
You did what?
Prostitution. I was young, beautiful, and elegant. So customers weren't a problem. I had sex with so many men that I saved up a whole lot of money within a year to get an apartment for us. And also, I started an online business. Got scammed 2 years after.
So when did you find out you had cancer?
3 years ago. The oncologist said it was due to multiple sex partners and excessive use of oral contraceptives.
So since you found out early, found out about the cancer very early, so why did you stop the chemotherapist?
I wanted to, but then money was the problem. And also, after the whole scam thing, the only priority I had was to make sure Amanda stayed back in school.
Is Amanda aware of all this?
No, sir. It will break her.
It's true.
Serious, my love. Mom was just tired.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I told you you worked too hard. Well, I was scared I was going to lose you.
Hey, my love. Nothing is going to happen to me, alright? It's you and I forever.
Of course.
Okay, that's enough. Let's go inside.
Alright. So,
baby, what happened to her?
She didn't tell you.
Though she was diagnosed with the disease early, she didn't commence treatment immediately. I'm afraid at this stage, chemotherapy can neither cure nor control the spread of cancer. It can only help to shrink the tumors that cause pain and pressure. These tumors often grow back to continue. It could have been controlled if only we started proper treatment earlier. I am sorry, Miss Anna, you have less than a year to live.
I don't want to die. I don't want to leave my child. I don't want to leave my child alone in this wicked world. I don't want to die. I don't want to die, sir. I don't want to die.
Anna?
Anna?
Ma?
Get me a glass of juice. Baby, do you care for?
No. No, I don't. Don't worry, I'll get it for her.
Why? Babe, this is why we pay her. She should go get it.
Ta is fine. I'll just get it.
Don't worry. Is there anything wrong with me getting something for my woman? Nothing wrong in it, right? 1 minute. So you can go. You get the car. Alright? Go get some rest. Okay? Alright. So.
Baby, what was that?
What is it?
Why did you get the drink yourself?
Oh, because I want to give my wife to be what she needs.
Is there a problem with that?
There's no problem with that. All I'm trying to say is that Anna is not feeling too well and she needs to rest.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I see. Then why don't we relieve her of her duties since she's not capable enough?
No, no, no. I did not know. I did not say she's not capable. I only say she's not feeling too well, so we should let her rest. Come on. Whatever you need, I will get for you, okay? You choose.
Baby, I don't like what you're doing.
I know.
Seriously.
I know.
You know I don't like it, right?
I know.
And you keep doing it.
Sorry. Just, you choose. Come on. So, come on. Come on. Please. Good?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We're saying something about your picture.
Okay. Uh-huh. So which one do you like? This.
Two it's way nice to see.
It's not zipping.
Wait.
I mean, I can't go to school with this bag. I can't go to school with this bag. This bag is too old. I've been using this bag for so long. And my classmates have changed back plenty times. I can't use it.
Baby, how can you be comparing yourself with your mates? Most of them are from wealthy homes. You know how things are.
I know, but I'm not asking for much now. Just a school bag, and that's all.
Okay.
Hello. Oh, baby, welcome.
Yeah, how are you?
How's work today?
Oh, fine, very good. And you? You didn't go out today?
I've been at home all day.
Not at all, like you didn't go out?
No, nowhere. Where will I go to start with? baby, you bought a new bag.
Oh, yeah, for Amanda.
Amanda?
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
Oh, you darling.
Welcome.
And how are you today?
Very fine. Welcome.
And I got you something. I got you a gift.
What? Oh my God! Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much.
You're welcome, darling. You're welcome.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. But you didn't have to do this.
Why? It's just a school bag.
Sir, it's just a school bag. I intend buying one for her by month end.
Okay, you intend getting one for her by month end. And so she'll stop going to school. I overheard you guys talking this morning, so I decided to get it for her. Alright.
Thank you.
You're welcome, darling.
Thank you so much, sir. Okay. God bless you. Thank
you. It's
alright. So, go fix it.
Okay.
Okay, sir, can I serve your food?
Oh, yes, go ahead and serve it.
Okay. Let me that one. But this one.
This one.
New one.
Yeah. All right, Surya, let me just freshen up, okay? Are you joining me? I'll see you later.
Are you sleeping with her?
What? Me? With who?
Yes. Are you having an intimate affair with Anna?
Chantel, I don't have anything with Anna, okay?
Then why do you always run after her daughter's needs? You practically attend to that girl's need like she's your own daughter. Why?
That is because I'm human and I feel that is the right thing for me to do.
Baby, there are limits to generosity.
God.
You pay her mother much more than she deserves. Baby, you drop her child off at school every morning. Baby, you bought an inhaler for her the other day. And today you bought her a new school bag. Not to forget the fact that you asked me to let her go because you think she was tired.
Well, that wasn't my making. That was the doctor's, what the doctor says, she should rest. Okay, after she fainted. The doctor asked that she should rest. Come on, please, I want babe. Look at this lady, look at this woman. She's a single mother, trying all she can just to satisfy her daughter. All we should do is just to help them, assist her, that's what we should do. Okay? I am not cheating on you. I can't cheat on you. That's the truth.
I hope so.
Come here.
My favorite show.
Then go and watch it in your room.
There is no TV in our room.
And what does that tell you? Say this one. Come on, you get out. Smell it. Just shoo. Get out.
You came earlier than we agreed.
Yes,
good morning.
I was around the neighborhood, so
I decided to come by instead of coming later.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
Okay, let me just go get the laptop so we can see what the architect sent of the designs and know which one we'll settle for.
Oh, that's
fine. Right. Okay.
Amanda, if you don't return that room.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, so, Joshua,
What do I offer you?
I'm fine, sir. I'm fine, sir.
Joshua, you can't be fine.
This is your first time visiting my home. So at least you can...
Just anything. Anything.
Oh, okay. Soft drink is okay. Soft drink.
Anna, you heard him.
All right, sir.
Okay, so... So, is that it?
I think this one is fine.
Yeah.
What do you hear?
The drinks.
So you were saying about the roofing?
The drinks, the roofing, yes, sir. The roofing of this particular one.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Baby, you go inside, I'll join you shortly. Alright?
Who is he?
I am...
He's Uncle Mark's friend. Go in. Come. Okay. I'll join you soon.
Alright.
Okay. I'll join you.
Uncle Mark's friend? Really?
What do you want?
My daughter.
What daughter?
The beautiful angel that just walked in.
You don't dare call her that. You hear me? Don't you ever in your entire miserable, lying, betraying God-forsaken mat call her that? What nonsense are you saying? What rubbish are you uttering? Do you have a child with me? Have you ever in your entire good-for-nothing life had anything intimate to do with me? Huh? We were just friends. Does it ring a bell?
Annabelle, I am very sorry. I was only but a kid. Please.
You know, it's obvious you're not just a betrayer, but also senseless and useless. You didn't know you were a kid when you were busy trusting in and out of me. You didn't know!
Annabelle, I am very sorry, like I said. And I am here to make amends. Trust me, I just want to be the best father Amanda will have.
Oh, Joshua.
Just give me a chance.
Joshua, you're looking for my trouble. And I swear to God Almighty, you will find that trouble you're looking for if you ever refer to my child as yours again. Leave this place and never return. Except as my boss colleague.
Annabelle,
I
am sorry. Look, I have been searching for you everywhere. And the moment I saw you in my boss's house, I knew fate wanted us back together. I am sorry.
Fate? Did you say fate? Don't touch me. Brit, one word of this to my boss. And I swear, I will make you regret the very day you stopped me on my way to the market to ask me out. Fool!
And
don't touch me! Do not!
It's me, okay? It's me.
Mommy, they said I should find X in this equation. I can't find it. Should I multiply? Or should I divide? I don't know. Mommy. Mom, are you okay?
Baby, I am fine.
No, I don't think so. Because you've not helped me with this equation since we started.
Mommy has a lot of things on her mind right now.
Is it about that man, Elia?
Uncle Mark's friend?
No! No, baby, no! It can never be about him, and it's not about him. Why do you think it's about him?
Because you've been acting somehow since we saw him.
Baby has nothing to do with him.
Fine. Well, welcome.
So how are you?
I'm not fine.
What is it?
Came back late today.
Today was a very, very busy and stressful day for me. Okay?
Welcome, sir.
Yeah.
Mom hasn't helped me in my mathematics questions since. I don't know what's wrong with her.
Okay, that shouldn't be a problem. You know what? I'll just go upstairs, freshen up, then I'll come down so we tackle the assignment.
I'll be waiting.
Alright.
Sir, should I serve your dinner?
And how are you today?
I'm very good, sir. Thank you.
You're not weak?
No, sir.
Everything is okay.
I'm okay, sir.
Alright, don't worry about the dinner. I ate something at work. I'm coming back. Just 3 minutes.
Okay. Why is it taking so long? It's more than 3 minutes.
Baby, Uncle Mark had a stressful day at work. He needs time to rest.
But he said 3 minutes.
Just wait for him, he will come.
I'm going to go call.
No, no, no. Wait.
He said 3 minutes. I'm coming.
This child.
Who is there? What do you want? Well, I'm sorry, Uncle Mark is not available, alright? You can ask your mother for help. Or better still, your dad. Go away, shoo! Leave the door, okay?
So that he can help me with the assignment.
What? She said...
What the hell is wrong with all of you in this house?
Chantel, the only reason I am not breaking your tiny bones right now is because you're Mr. Mark's fiancé. And I have a lot of respect for him. But the next time you speak to my child the way you did a while ago, I promise you I'll let go of every respect in me and beat you blue black.
Oh, really? You have the nerves, the effrontery to come inside this room to threaten me, right?
Listen. Listen to
me! Are you something wrong with your head? How dare you!
How dare you speak to my fiance in that manner?
Sir, maybe if she had learned the things to say to a child, I would learn how to be more respectful when speaking to her.
Oh, really?
What are you talking about?
Amanda came up here to look for you to assist with her homework. And Miss Chantel told my child to go and ask me to call her father to help her. Who says that to a child?
But that's the truth. She should look for her father.
What?
I am letting go because of my boss. But do not try this again.
Baby, listen. Whatever you...
Thank you.
kind Auntie Chantel. Okay? Ignore whatever she had said to you.
Amanda, it's okay. Stop crying, okay? And don't mind Auntie Chantel. I'm going to do your homework with you. Alright? Any other homework, bring to me, I'll do for you. Okay?
Promise.
A promise across my heart.
Pinky swear.
Baby,
stop. Now listen to me. The next time you speak to that child in that manner, you won't like what I'll do to you. Just a word from you.
Leave before my madam comes and meets you here.
Wait. What makes you feel I don't want her to meet me here?
Look, Annabelle, I need my child. And I want her like right now.
What nonsense are you spinning? What rubbish are you saying? What child? No, tell me what child. Do you have any child with me?
I don't need a soothsayer to tell me that Amanda is my child. Come on, look at it now.
The same child you denied while she was still a fetus. The same pregnancy you denied and made my parents disown me. Have you any idea what went through? What I went through because of you?
Annabelle, I'm sorry. Trust me, I didn't know what I was doing. I am sorry. Let me make things right.
Well, I don't give a screw what you were or weren't doing. The only thing I care about right now is that you leave. Leave us alone. I don't need you. My child, she doesn't need you.
Annabelle, I have tried to have a decent conversation with you regarding this. And from the look of things, you don't want it. But I must have my child, whether you like it or yes.
Oh. Joshua, is that supposed to be a threat?
Speaking of threats, you can call it whatever you want. I must have my child.
Must have what? Now listen to me. You know me. Joshua, you know me very well.
Yes, sir.
You know I don't like repeating myself. You know, right?
Yes, sir.
Now I'm going to give you two options. Two options if you still want to work in my company. Now listen to me. Two options. You forget about Amanda and Anna, that you ever met them in my house. Is that clear?
Yes,
and
sir,
secondly, sir, if you don't like that, you can go to court. And you know if you go to court, I will definitely win you. Now get up and leave my house, yes, you sir, swine.
Or what do you think?
Mom. Baby. It's time to prepare for school.
Baby. It's high time you started practicing what I've been teaching you. Today, you have to get yourself ready for school. Okay?
Okay. Mom, are you alright?
I'm fine, my love. I'm okay. Fine.
Okay, let me go freshen up then. Wait, does that mean you're not taking me to school today?
No, baby. I won't. Mommy is very tired and weak. Just remove the money in my purse. Buy yourself something during break.
Okay. If you're not going to take me, then I'll wait for Uncle Mark.
No, baby. Don't bother him, please.
He won't be bothered. Don't worry. Just...
Yes.
Good morning, Uncle Mark. Good morning, Auntie Chantel.
How are you?
I'm very, very fine, sir.
And your mom?
She's still in bed. She said she's a little tired.
Oh, yeah, she needs to rest them all. Mm-hmm. Okay? So you just have to leave her to rest. Okay, so let's go. Off to school.
Okay.
Come on, I'll help you with the bag.
Oh, thank you.
Good morning, Auntie. Let's go. I'll see you later. Bye. And please later just check on Anna, okay? And make sure she's good.
Why is there no food on this table? Oh my god, this is even looking so dusty. Anne! Annabelle! Anna!
Ma!
Oh my god. Oh my god, I can't just take this anymore. Yes.
Ma.
Wait, don't tell me you're still sleeping.
No, Ma, not really.
Then what?
Ma. I'm not feeling too strong. I feel very weak and I'm tired.
Oh.
Yes,
and how is that my business? I repeat, how is that my business? So because you're not feeling too strong, only God knows where you went last night. Because you're not feeling too strong, Anna, I should starve. I should starve to death. You want me to die? No, Anna, you want to kill me now? No, no, you want to kill me in my fiance's house? Anna, before I open these eyes, please, get to that dining and make yourself very useful. I don't want to do something nasty to you. Just carry yourself, jejeje. Waka go that dining. Sit down! Oh yeah! Halile! Be going! What's this up? I said be fast! My God. Don't make me meet you there because you're not gonna like my color this morning. Be fast about it.
Ma. What would you like to have?
Wait. Did you just ask me that question?
Sorry.
Have you suddenly gone dumb? So ever since your stay in this house, you don't know my favorite meal in the morning. You don't know what I take in the morning, right? Eh?
Okay. Just fix it.
Crocodile tears. Those fake tears of yours is what you use to deceive my fiancé. Ha! This girl, eh? You know go better for you. God forbid. Useless thing. Madam, don't waste my time. I repeat, do not waste my time. And hey, listen. If you guys, your people eat in the village in a very dirty environment, I don't do that, okay? Make sure you dust that dining. If possible, get rag, get water. You know, massage the dining well, clean it well, proper, before you serve any food on that table.
Okay. I'll just get rag to clean it up.
Anna, you just have 5 minutes.
Okay.
This girl is trying. What sort of lazy asshole? That's how you just get fat, you don't do anything in this house, you're just lazing about. Maybe because you eat too much, that's why. I think I need to tell my face to cut down the meals in this house so you don't eat anything anymore. Useless thing. What's this drama for now? Eh? No, what's the whole drama for? Okay, because you don't want to work, right? You're pretending to be, peace in this house.
What is it?
Baby, wait.
There is no need for that, sir.
That
will be a waste of time and resources. The doctor said I have less than a year to live. It's been over a year, so I need. Good enough to. I feel good enough to speak to you, or at least. At least, yes. Sir, they say God comes to us all in human form. But to me, and my daughter, you've been our God. Thank you, sir.
It's okay, man.
You accepted us as family, not as workers. You did things that most parents wouldn't do for their children. Sir, I have nobody in this world to leave my daughter with except you and Miss Chantel. Sir, please promise me you will take care of her. Promise me you will take care of her, look after her. See, she's old enough to fend for herself. She's the only thing I have in this world. She's my sweet child. My sweet girl, please. Promise me you will let Joshua take her.
I promise you, okay? I promise you that I'm going to take care of Amanda. Like my own child.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. You are an honorable man. And your words mean everything to me. Thank you, sir.
She wants to talk to you.
Who, me?
In the room.
Why? Okay.
No, she might be surprised why I asked that I speak to you.
Sorry.
It is obvious you love Mr. Mark as much as he loves you. I have asked that he helps me look after my child.
It's okay.
But you see, he's not the one that will look after her, but you. Please, do this.
It's okay.
Do this for your dying mother. Please. I know this might not be what you planned. Please. Amanda is the only thing I have left in this world. She can be naughty at times, but trust me, she's a very sweet child, a very sweet girl. Please, Chantel. Promise me you will always look out for her. Promise me you will always correct her when need be.
It's okay. It's okay. Easy.
Please. I had her childhood. Please. Have her adulthood. Chantel, grant me this one wish. I shall die a happy mother.
You're not going to die. You will live for the sake of your child. Are you strong? Okay? I promise to look after Amanda.
Thank you.
I will take her as my child.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's okay. Amanda, I am so sorry.
Why are you going to die?
My love, I am not going to die. It's me and you forever. I will stay with you and watch you grow into an elegant, beautiful woman. I will stay with you and watch you in your wedding gown as you marry. Okay? Mom is going to stay with you forever. It's just a little sickness. But Uncle Mark promised me that nothing will happen to me. I'll stay with you. Okay? It's me and you. Thank you.
Amanda, please open the door.
Go away. Go away.
Amanda, please open the door. It's been 2 days after the burial and you still haven't come out. You still haven't eaten. Please, just come out. Come out and eat.
Leave me alone. Just go away. Leave me alone.
Amanda, if anything happens to you, I will definitely not forgive myself.
Amanda, please open the door, okay? At least so you can eat, then you can go back and lock yourself inside. Just come out, okay? Just come and eat. Amanda! Amanda, please!
That's fine. If this door is still locked, if she doesn't open and I come back from work tomorrow, we'll have no option now to break the door.
Maybe I'm scared. I'm scared for Amanda.
She still hasn't opened. By the time I return from work and that door is still locked, I'll have no option than to break it down.
Have something to eat, okay? Amanda, please open this door, I beg you. Amanda!
See you alive, not dead. So you need to eat something.
What if the reason she's still in there
It's because of me.
Because of you? Why?
I was so mean. I was so disrespectful. I was so callous to them. I didn't know Anna was sick. I swear, I thought she was faking it all along. I thought she was pretending just to get your attention or something. I didn't know she was truly ill. I swear. I didn't know Anna was sick. I didn't know Anna was sick. I didn't know.
Amanda isn't in that room because of you. She's not in there because of you. No, it's not because of you. And she's a child. I mean, she can hold grudges. Okay? Please.
Okay.
And where are you going to?
Amanda, I know you're still in there. Amanda, please, I am so sorry. Find a place in your heart to forgive me. I know what I did to you and your late mom is not fair. I know that, but this is me apologizing to you from the depth of my heart. Amanda, I am truly sorry. Amanda, everything I have done to you, I promise to make it up, okay? I'm sorry. I didn't know your mom wasn't feeling all right. Amanda, please.
I want to eat noodles.
You want to eat noodles? Okay. It'll be ready in 5 minutes, okay? I'll be right back. Maybe, yes. Yes, I'm coming.